The original Baja Blastin dune jumpin Ford Raptor has returned for a third generation. But while Ford may have originated the off-road ready truck craze over a decade ago, some serious competition has stepped up to challenge Ford in this domain. So can the Blue Oval's latest and greatest still lay claim to the throne? Well, let's find out. There's no way around it. The new Raptor just looks so tough in person, and really, right at home on this dusty trail outside of Los Angeles. In particular, I love the Velocity Blue metallic paint, which pops so nicely against all this graphite gray trim you'll find on the Raptor. Of course, we have a Raptor-specific bumper up front and this really aggressive grille with the Ford script in the middle. But the big news that Raptor fans care about is actually behind me. The Raptor has 17-inch beadlock wheels and matching graphite, which look really nice. But the big news is that while a 35-inch tire is standard on these things, and that's already quite large, there is the option now to get even more massive 37-inch BFG all-terrain tires here, which Ford claims are the largest tires ever fit into a production truck. And I mean, just look how huge these things are. Due to the Raptorized frame underneath the body of this truck, the 2022 Raptor is only available in what Ford calls the Super Crew. It's a four-door crew cab. And check out some niceties down here, like these dual-function rock sliding rails and step guards. Looks pretty tough. The other part of that deal is that you are bound to a 5.5-foot box, which is fine for most people, but there's some pretty cool functionality baked into this thing. First things first, we have a power one-touch liftgate, which is a nice feature, and yes, it's one touch up and one touch down, quite cool. Then there are some nice general F-150 things. I like, for example, the fact that this is a giant ruler right here on the bed. That's quite handy for doing any sort of work. Also, we do this optional spray and bed liner, which is a nice touch. And I also like the inclusion of a power supply and lighting back here, which is really handy. It's also cool that we have an onboard generator, which is really handy when you are on the trail or at the campsite. But one caveat about the Raptor is, as great as this thing is on the road and clearly off the road, there are some small trade-offs to this package compared to other F-150s. Take, for example, towing. While this truck does have the optional towing package, it's limited to just a towing capacity of 8,200 pounds. Other F-150 models can crest over 10,000 pounds. That's just one of the inherent trade-offs of this package. Under the hood, we have an EcoBoost 3.5-liter twin-turbocharged V6 that's good for 450 horse and a massive 510 pound-feet of torque. Naturally, the Raptor is four-wheel drive and power sent to all four wheels via a 10-speed automatic transmission. Now, Ford enthusiasts might recognize that this is basically a carryover powertrain from the previous second-generation Raptor that debuted in 2017. However, there are a few quality of life improvements, such as a louder, more prominent 3-inch exhaust system, which helps the engine breathe a little better, and a functional heat extractor in the hood right here. As you might expect from looking at this thing, fuel economy is not exactly stellar. With the optional 37-inch tires, the Raptor returns an EPA fuel economy figure of 14 mpg city, 16 mpg on the freeway, and 15 mpg combined. Though I suspect approximately 0% of Raptor buyers will care about that. The Raptor's interior is quite nice. It builds on all the basic things I really like about the standard F-150 and just Raptorifies things here and there. The fit and finish and the colors and materials feel really nice. I love all the different textures happening in here with the Raptorified touches. This example is blue on the outside and blue on the inside, like these blue Recaro seats, which are very comfortable and look really nice. This same blue colorway can be found across the dash and on the door cards up here, so it just feels really cohesive and upscale. This Raptor test vehicle has a few options added to it, of course, one of the most prominent ones being Equipment Group 801A. Really catchy name, I know. It costs $6,000 and adds in a mix of hardware, like a front limited slip differential and a towing package, along with a bunch of interior goodies that you want to know about. Like an 18-speaker Bang & Olufsen audio system, a heated steering wheel, built-in navigation to this 12-inch touchscreen down here, wireless phone charging, and crucial, in my opinion, is the 360-degree camera system, which is excellent in this vehicle. If any of those options are important to you, be sure to tick that box in the options list. And let's go back to this 12-inch touchscreen display here, which is the latest version of Ford's Sync 4 system. It's a nice blend of a touchscreen with physical controls around the system And I like the interface overall. It's simple and straightforward, and the buttons and prompts on the screen itself are quite large and easy to press while driving. In tandem with this 12-inch infotainment display is the central driver display right here. No analog gauges, it's a full digital display, and it's really cool. It has some neat party tricks. Like when you toggle between the drive modes, there's a great animation that shows you what parts of the truck change, because this Raptor is very, very adjustable. You can adjust the steering feel, or the shock absorbers, or the bimodal exhaust. So it looks just really nice and makes this thing feel really upscale. And more just general nice truck stuff. There's a lot of plugs and chargers in here that I really enjoy. Plugs there, USB outlets down there, and in this massive storage compartment, more USB outlets down there. And speaking of this storage compartment, I actually like this. This is a general F-150 thing. You can fold this down flat. You can fold the shifter down flat, and then pull this out to create a workstation. As you might expect from a vehicle of this size, the Raptor's back seat is very generous. I'm 6'1", I have several inches of knee room here, very comfy indeed, and several inches of headroom, making for a very comfortable place to spend time. Also helping that out is the inclusion of air vents back here for better circulation, along with heated rear seats, which are a nice touch. Oh, and don't forget the obligatory charging ports, of which there are many. Man, it's funny, our little test trail here is just no match for the might of the Raptor. It seriously flattens out every little kink in the road and just makes it feel as if it's like nothing. And a big part of that is absolutely the aforementioned 37-inch tire package, which comes with a slightly modified frame to clear them, along with different Fox Racing off-road shocks, which similarly just makes smooth work of this. This thing actually does ride quite nicely off-road, all things considered. Another perk of going with the 37s on the Raptors, you gain an inch of ground clearance, along with an extra 2 degrees of approach and departure angles, which are 33 and 25 respectively. So this thing really can do some serious wheeling off-road, despite its rather large size. For those of you doing the math at home, you may have realized this Raptor test vehicle basically has about 15 grand worth of options thrown at it, and that brings the price up to $80,000 as tested, which is basically the same price as a nicely equipped Ram TRX, another truck we reviewed on this channel with similar off-road and on-road extreme performance. However, for the numbers nerds out there, while the Raptor is no slouch, this thing can do 0 to 60 in under 6 seconds, it is down quite a lot in the horsepower department compared to the almighty TRX back there, which has over 700 horsepower thanks to a massive supercharged V8 under the hood. Now, if the idea of the Raptor appeals, and to be frank, it should, this is a really nice package overall, but you just want more performance, you just want more. Well, the rumor around Dearborn is that Ford is dropping a big old supercharged V8 under the hood of the Raptor and calling it the Raptor R. With a theoretical 700 plus horsepower under the hood, after all, that same engine in the Mustang GT500 cracks 760 horsepower, this thing would be an absolute blast. I mean, we already get wheel spin off the line in first gear in this thing, so chuck an extra 300 horsepower at it and man, he'd really be cooking with gas. But that's then and this is now, and I think the really impressive thing about the Raptor is its duality, because this thing is fantastic on the road. One of the big talking points about this third generation Raptor is the rear suspension. Ford has swapped in a 5-link rear suspension with coil springs, so this thing does actually have great on-road performance. It's comfortable, which is surprising, because a lot of trucks, when you jack up the suspension, put big tires on them, tend to trade a lot of that on-road civility. But the Raptor's duality is just really, really impressive and apparent as soon as you drive this thing around town. And similarly, while the EcoBoost V6 might not be everyone's flavor, the efficacy is just, wow, it's so potent. It has so much down-low torque, and when paired to this 10-speed transmission, makes this thing feel really snappy and really urgent. It's funny, this level of on-road civility is just a real welcome surprise for me, especially having driven the previous generation Raptor. This is a genuinely daily drivable truck that if you want to, you can go do some serious like dune jumping with. And so I just really like how flexible this thing is overall. That said, while I brought up the Ram TRX as probably the alpha male of off-road extreme, borderline insane trucks, there are some other competitors worth thinking about here. There's also the recently announced Silverado ZR2, which should notably improve off-road performance of the Silverado compared to the current Trail Boss, and more closely line up with the Raptor. Looking at the Raptor as a whole, I really like this package. I think Ford is offering a really competitive truck here that does just blend this everyday usability with just fantastic off-road prowess. And the idea of a forthcoming Raptor R just gives me that much more excited because, man, this package just seems so good that why not try throwing more horsepower at it if you got it? Of course, if you want to learn more about the new Ford Raptor or any other trucks I've mentioned in this video, you can click the link in the description down below or go to Autobytel.com.